Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another awesome tutorial in Revit Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create parametric hexagon structure in Revit. This tutorial we are combination with our hexagon shape plus our triangle shape to create our structure component, wood component none. After that only we are creating our concept schema to create our architect visualization session for this project. And anyway, this is your first time reaching out to my channel and visiting to my channel. You didn't know about me yet. My name is Ben from Revit Global Knowledge. I'm going to help you from zero to hero and from beginner level to professional level. Make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for notification for learn more about Revit. Okay, now let's stick around together for this tutorial. As you can see in my screen, there is my previous hexagon structure that I have created one. We will start to create those kind of steps from start to finish. I would like to close the project first. I think anyway, we go to create another file first. Go to my file over there, drop down for new here. Okay, sorry about that. Go to file again, go to new. We go to our family, just like our family here. English for metric. Just go down finding for metric generic model pattern batch. I just double click for this one. Okay, as you can see, we are in our pattern batch, but here is a rectangle set. We want to use for those kind of hexagon set. So I just like here one, and then I drop down finding for hexagon this one. For the dimension and horizontal spacing and vertical spacing, I would like to change as well. Just make it for 800 by 800 millimeter. Cap again, Control V. Okay, it's apply. Okay, perfect. Now we got our hexagon shape there. I would like to add triangle shape here. So I need to place reference point on the center first. By place that, I need to go to my reference here. Then I can start from here until here, hit escape, just like point here, finding for the center point here, like this, just like the center point here. And then on my property panel there, we got offset for parametric. I would like to assign for parameter first. Go to new here, just make it for triangle center point. Triangle, yep, hit okay, and then we just hit finish. Go to my family tie over there. I would like to center point, would like to offset for 400 millimeter. Let's apply, it's okay. And for the reference there, I would like to delete. Okay, perfect. Now it's time to create our triangle set. I just go to my reference here, just like my line here. Make sure turn on for 3D snapping and chain. I just start from this point until okay, just we need to use for Chinese font to draw by first because we are working on 3D. Yeah, then I would like to connect here, hit escape. As you can see, we got our triangle shape. Let's continue and place that. Hit escape again, go to another side here. Hit escape again. Okay, perfect. Now I want to create some glass on the bottom first. By create that, I just select all my component over there. Let me find first. Okay, perfect. Go to create form there, solid form. Finding for the small one, yep, or the big one. Then I just select my whole panel there, over there. Hit a tab key on my keyboard. Go to my material here. I would like to assign for part material first. Create U, make it for glass. It's okay. Firmly tie over there. Glass panel. Change this one to glass. Apply. Then it's okay. Now it's time to create our structure. By create that, I need to place some point and some reference circle first. Just go to my reference again. Select my point here. Draw on first. Again, draw here like this. Go to circle here. First again. Okay, I need to set a work plan first. Set a work plan for horizontal one. Sorry, for vertical one. Okay, let me select again. I think we go wrong. Okay. Great. So I make it for 40. Hit escape. Then I can select this point here and the circle here as well. Okay, so I can copy that. CO for copy. I'm going to copy a few circles. Hit escape. Select my point here. Sorry about that. Select my point here. Pick a new host sphere. Just pick for this guy over there. Select another guy here. Okay, this one I want to rotate a bit easier for me. Okay, let me see first. Okay, we need to place another one here. Hit escape a couple times. Let's turn around and take a look. Is it everything is fine? Okay, good. It's time to place our it's time to get our structure. I just like my circle here, then select this guy over there. 1 and 2, 3. 4, 5, and okay, sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Create form, solid form. Okay, perfect. I just lay my whole structure here. I need to assign for a new material first. Create, okay. Create new, make it for wood structure. Then I can hit OK again. Go to family tie over there. Create a new material. Rename it for wood structure. Asset browser over there. Appearance library, finding for wood, and we are using for bird. I think bird is okay one. Apply is okay. Apply is okay. Okay, let's continue to add our structure element. Okay, another guy there. We haven't assigned for material yet, so we need to place that. I just like all my structure here for the slant one. Okay, perfect. As you can see, we got our hexagon shape for bottom and triangle shape over there for the top one. Let's go to our file there. We need to create a new concept tool first. Go to new, go to family over there. English here, concept tool mask, double click. Okay, I would like to go to my level 1 first to place another reference plane. Go to place here, then pick line. I can offset this one for 5 meter. Pick line here. Hit escape. Perfect. Go to my reference here, select point. I can place one by one. Hit escape, reference, split line, spread through line. Hit escape, go to my 3D over there, select the first line there, 1, 2, 3, create form, solid form. Okay, good. It's time to offset for our point here, and of course this one you can assign for parameter as well, as you can see for offset that, but I will skip for this one because I don't want to take time on it. Then I just start select for the center one here. For offset over there, I think made it for 3.1 meter. Apply. Okay, for the corner here, for the center here as well, for the right side I would like to make it for I don't know, just make it for, yeah, make it something like this. Apply. Okay, and there I want to make it to 3800. And here as well, 3840. Okay, the last step, I will make it higher a bit, 4640. Apply. Good. Now we got our parametric shape here. Sorry, our conceptual shape here. I need to go to my 3D one for component there. I would like to load into project. Family stick, yep. Go to my 3D over there. I can select the whole form here. Device surface. And this one, I just select or go to family file that we create one for component. It will be take a few seconds. This one will be skip, and let's see the result together when one is done for file it generating. Alright, here is our result after we generating, but not what I want because the structure here why not connection, and this one we got problem also for our glass there. So what I'm going to do, I just like my whole structure here, then this one I'm going to change it for to overhanging, and from the layout one I'm going to change it to fix this, then make it for 800, and this guy I want to make it for this, then make it for 800 as well. Then hit apply. Then file will be generating again. I think will be take a few seconds, but let's wait and see the result together. Okay, as you can see. And here is what we have done for our conceptual architect for our parametric stress. For this one, we combine this with our hexagon set plus our triangle set. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial, as you can see. Thank you for watching from start to finish, and make sure hit subscribe for learn more about Revit. Thank you guys for joining me from start to finish, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit. Thank you.